Hello friends, this is Durga again from IT Varsity, a one-stop shop to learn all the technologies. At this time, we are talking about setting up Hadoop core components. And so far, we have seen HDFS, we have seen MR1 Classic, and now we will be talking about Yarn, and eventually, we will actually set up Yarn using Cloudera Manager. So Yarn stands for Yet Another Resource Negotiator. So as I have explained earlier, when you submit a MapReduce job, or when you submit any job in the Hadoop cluster, it has to run gracefully with the other jobs that are running at that time. So to manage all these jobs without failing, to share the resources effectively and efficiently, we need to have tools or frameworks. And we have seen Classic already, which only understands the MapReduce jobs, MR1 or Classic, which only understand MapReduce jobs and which can actually make sure your jobs up and running all the time. But there are few challenges and it is not completely efficient. To address those challenges which I have explained earlier, they have come up with this generic job management tool which can share resources between MapReduce based distributed processing tools as well as non-MapReduce based distributed processing. Even within MapReduce based distributed processing, with Yarn, they have tried to mitigate some of the issues such as underutilization or contention of resources as mappers and reducers are pre-configured. In Classic, the map tasks and reduce tasks are pre-configured, whereas in Yarn, it is not the case. So there are many features like that which you need to be aware of when it comes to Yarn. We will again compare MR1 Classic and Yarn towards the end of the session, towards the end of the topic in some other video. But by the time you complete this topic, you need to have clear differences between Classic and Yarn. Okay, and when it comes to Yarn architecture, you need to understand what are the daemon processes that are involved. So there is a master which is called as resource manager. It is typically one in the cluster. There will be slaves, one each of the data node, and that slave is called as node manager. And then, as I have mentioned to you, Yarn can submit or can work with different technologies. That's why they have used something called application. Which is generic, which is applicable for both MapReduce and non-MapReduce tools. So any MapReduce job or other non-MapReduce jobs which are submitted are categorized into application. So when you use Yarn, you will be submitting different types of jobs. You can submit different types of jobs using Yarn. One is MapReduce, another is Spark. Another is Impala, many other things can be integrated over time. So App Timeline Server will actually give the application level details. You will understand what those application level details when we actually configure it. Within the cluster, you can run as many MapReduce jobs as you want. And for each MapReduce job, you need to keep track of the history, means you need to see how the job have performed when it was executed. So all these things can be retrieved using another component called history server. So App Timeline Server is YARN specific. So at the YARN level, when the application is submitted, it will give you the details what is happening for that application. Whereas history server is for MapReduce job. How the map tasks are executed and reduce tasks are executed, etc. And also there is the per job application master which we will not be configuring, but it will be running for each and every job. You will understand once we run the MapReduce job, and also I will demonstrate how the entire architecture works later. First we will configure the Yarn on the cluster. So unlike MRU1, there are two parameter files, yarnside.xml and mapreduce.xml. So yarnside.xml will have parameters related to resource managers and node managers. Mapreduce.xml file will have parameters related to mappers and reducers. And then You have multiple web interfaces. One is Resource Manager web interface, another one is Application Master web interface, and third one is Job History Server web interface. We will see all those things once the yarn is configured. And then you need to understand the log files the way you have understood with respect to HDFS and Classic. So this is how we will set up on the cluster. If there are three masters and three slaves, in one of the masters or client, we will have client, which is master 01 in our 7-node cluster. We are using 7-node cluster, not 6. And out of three masters, client will be set up on master 01. And master 02 and master 03 already have active name node and passive name node. So name nodes are configured in those two. We will set up resource manager also on master 03. So in production cluster, resource manager will go to its own server. It will not be deployed on the same node where the name node is being running. Okay, but as we have limited resources, we will be sharing resource manager on name node and name node on the same physical server. These are all software process which can be co-located, but when it comes to production, the best practice is to have node a name node on one node and resource manager on other node. Name node is the master for HDFS and resource manager is the master for yarn. And then we will configure app timeline server and history server also on master 03. So this is how we started. We have set up YAM, then we have set up Cloudera manager with Cloudera manager agents, and then we have set up HDFS, and now we will be setting up YAM plus MR2. Okay, so let me configure it using Cloudera manager. Again, to add a new service, you have to click on this icon and click on add a service. And here we are trying to set up yarn plus MR2. So when you configure yarn, MR2 also will be included as part of Cloudera distribution. Hit continue. And if you also read for the text associated with it, Apache Hadoop MapReduce 2 or yarn is a data computation framework that supports MapReduce applications, and it requires HDFS. So you have to first set up HDFS before adding yarn or MapReduce. And most of the services are directly dependent on HDFS or indirectly. So except Zookeeper, you cannot set up anything unless HDFS is configured and is up and running. Anyway, hit continue. So it is picking 242 as for the resource manager, but I will be using 244 for resource manager. Click on OK. Job history server also, I will be setting up on 244. And node manager, 245 to 248. Automatically it has selected the nodes where the data nodes are running. So you can preview here. So data nodes and name node managers are running on all these four nodes. And resource manager and job history server are running on 244. It also have name node, but we typically will not set up name node and resource manager on the same physical server in case of production clusters. Click on OK. Click on continue. And here again, these are local directories as you have seen in Classic. Okay, so very limited options it will provide to modify while adding the service. If you want to override, you have to go to the configuration section of the service and you can override the parameters later. Hit on continue. And now it is actually deploying the configuration files, which are ansite.xml and mapreduce.xml files. And then it will actually start creating DFS directories for yarn. Yarn requires some of HDFS directories so that it actually stores the job history in HDFS itself, and then it will start the yarn process. The services are started. Click on continue. Click on finish. And now yarn is set up on the cluster. and we can click on this and see the status section. There is one job history server, four node managers and one resource manager, but you don't see app timeline server here, but when you click on resource manager, so with respect to Cloudera, app timeline server is embedded within the yarn itself, so it will not show separate link, but if you are looking through Ambari, you will see app timeline server also. So wherever resource manager is running, app timeline server will also be running, and we will be able to access through web interface, which I will show later, and these are the services which are added. So that being said, this is how you can actually configure yarn using Cloudera manager. You can also set up high availability on the resource manager by clicking on resource manager actions. One minute, or you have to go to Cloudera manager. Yeah, to enable high availability, you have to go to Cloudera manager, click on yarn at the service level, click on actions, and you will see enable high availability. You can click on this. And now you can actually select the second host for the high availability. So in this case, if you want to set up on 243, you can choose 243 here. And then now you can see resource manager is running on both the nodes. Click on OK, click on continue. And then it will actually add the high availability. So it will stop the running service, it will add standby resource manager, it will start yarn and its dependent services. And finally, it will deploy the updated client configuration files, which are nothing but yarnside.xml and mapreadside.xml files. So now everything came up gracefully. Click on finish. And now you can see the status. There are two resource managers. One is in unknown health, but it will turn green very soon. And you have one four node managers and one job history server to actually get the history of all our MapReduce jobs. If you click on instances, it will show all the instances running resource manager, node managers and job history servers. And if you see, there is no gateway. Again, if you try to run the jobs from 242, as it does not have a gateway configured for yarn, it will try to run the MapReduce jobs locally, which is not good. So we need to configure gateway on 242. There is no 242 in this list. So click on add role instances, select gateway, and I want to configure gateway on 242. Click on OK, click on continue, and you will see the deploy stale configure stale configurations icon here. If you click on it, it will take you to the review changes section, and then you can click on deploy client configuration. Again, it will show deploy client configuration button here. You have to click on that. Now the configuration files of the updated cluster will be deployed on 242, so that we can run MapReduce jobs from there. Not only MapReduce jobs, but also any yarn application from there, which includes the MapReduce jobs. Okay, so that's the configuration portion is done. First, we have configured resource manager first we have configured yarn with one resource manager, and then we have configured high availability, and also we have made 242 as gateway, so that we can submit the MapReduce jobs from the 242. MapReduce jobs are yarn applications, which includes MapReduce jobs from the gateway node. That being said, as part of the next video, I will review all the components which are and also the parameter files, log files, and also validation aspects of it in the next video. That being said, if you like this video, please click on the like button. If you want to provide the feedback, please use the comment section of the video. If you want to discuss further about the big data certifications, please join my LinkedIn group called itversity-bigdata-certifications. If you are not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. And also, if you live in countries like US, UK, where fan funding or support the channel feature is available, if you want to support me, you can see the support this channel section here, and you can contribute anywhere between $1 to $500 so that I can focus more on publishing content covering vast area of technologies. Thank you. Bye.